Welcome back to Wasteland 2. The Temple of Titan should be somewhere around here. Let's try to find it. And I've already talked to this Dale person here, who is a crazy motherfucker. I don't want to try to help him because I'm worried that he might get us into trouble. What the hell is this? Looks like there was a platform in between these two areas here, but it just, like, completely collapsed. Looks like somebody used to live there. Hello. Right, I don't have a monk anymore, which means if somebody attacks me, well, there's no one there to protect me. Although, if they don't have a monk either, then I can shoot them without any problems. Because then they're also not under the peace of Titan. And I don't see a monk, so I might be okay to shoot them. If I have to. Let's try to avoid that, though. So let's try to go a different way if we can. Because it looks like they're itching for a fight. Oh. Okay. So all the raiders want to kill me. Gotcha. Okay, well this monk suicider is green, so I guess they're not going to try to kill me. I hope. Oh, he's a lobber. Ow. It didn't actually do much damage, but it did a lot of damage. It did a lot of little damage to a bunch of people. Which adds up to a lot of damage. I wonder if these red barrels are explosive. Probably not, because these look like the ones that would actually blow up. These don't. They're more orange than red. Alright, let's burst this. Beautiful. It's kind of disturbing to say I just shot off a man's arm and it's beautiful, but it kind of is. Well, I mean, not the blowing up of his arm, but the fact that this gun performed so wonderfully. You're no match for me, Raider Smig. What's their armor? Two? It's not worth using an energy weapon on him. And she can't get out of here because everybody's blocking her ways, so... run over here. Let's try to take out the grenadier. Grenadier? Grenadier. Sharpshooter. It's gonna start sniping at our people. I really want this guy dead. Should I sharpshoot the sharpshooter? What if he could actually shoot me from there? I'd be surprised. I mean, I can't shoot him from here, and the range on this thing is 33 meters. And that's with an upgrade. Ooh, I can actually hit both of them from here. Yeah, I'm really liking that over-under shotgun. It's really nice. I think it actually may have single-handedly turned her from a rather terrible class into an actually useful one. Well, I shouldn't say class, because there's really no class, but, you know, she was kind of the shotgun class. And before she just sucked, but now she's actually kind of good. Okay, he can't shoot me from up there. That's what I thought. That's a terrible chance to hit. Let's just ambush. God, that's really bad, too. He's too close. I'm not gonna waste the ammo. Alright, let's just get near this guy, so hopefully we scare him away or something. Although he does have an SMG, so maybe he won't actually go away. Because an SMG is probably best used up close. Oh, there we go. Got this guy coming up. Let's take cover. He's like, nope. Actually, I think he's realized that we've gotten close enough that he actually can start shooting us. Probably just Yulia, though. Okay, if I move here, I might be able to shoot him. Not quite. I'm like one tile too short. Any cover? No cover, huh? Alright, well, he doesn't really have cover from us either. So our sniper should be able to get him. Let's move up, though. Whoa, whoa! What the hell? Why did my view just move all the way to the left side? Some sort of voodoo controlled it for a second there. Okay, I think I actually can shoot him right now. Yes, 90% too, despite the height disadvantage for us. Nice. Yeah, how does it feel now, sharpshooter? Don't feel so sharp now that you're missing part of your brain, do you? You get two shots? Damn. Move a bit closer. Get a little hit advantage bonus here. Alright, we need to do some healing.
Copy range. Congratulations.
And he's bleeding. Should I heal that? Can I heal that? Do I actually have... No, I don't have any sutures. Okay, at least we're through the really bad medic packs. So this should be a lot easier, a lot quicker. Yeah, much better. That still took a surprising amount of time, though. I need to find somebody to sell my weapons to really quickly, because almost everybody's overloaded at this point. Let's go ahead and spend Vulture's Cries skill points. Oh my god, she has so many! Is anybody else sitting on like a huge amount of points? You have 4. Let's upgrade your field medic. Okay. So I'm mostly using her safe cracking and sniper rifle skill. Let's just upgrade her sniper rifle skill. It's actually lagging behind her safe cracking. Ooh. What's that down here? Aw, I was just using that sniper rifle. It's not very good, to be honest. I thought the short range of it, the 23 meter range, wouldn't be too bad, but it actually was pretty bad. Yay, cracked dentures! Exactly what I wanted. Oh, I can actually go down there. Okay, so pathways. I can go up here to these raiders that are undoubtedly going to try to kill me. Or I can go up here. Oh, I missed this. Up here to something. Or I can go here. There's a doorway there to something. To what? Is it the entrance to the temple? Doesn't look like a temple entrance. Looks like something else. Let's go see what's over here. So there's actually four pathways. Two ways over there, one way down here, and then one way up here. More raiders. Yeah, once again, they don't have any monks with them, so I might as well just shoot them. In fact, they might even start combat with me. Oh, Diamondback Militia. What are you doing down here? Alright. Well, let's see if these guys want to kill us. I think they will. Let's see if they want to talk. Nope. Haha. That's what you get for not maintaining your weapon. Remember to oil your weapon frequently. Do they have a grenadier amongst them? Lobber, yep. Fuck you. Go ahead and move her away. Let's get her far away. You know, it might be time to burst. How much? Am I doing pretty good on ammo? 73? Yeah, I'm doing fine. Oh no! You hurt me so bad! Once again, their armor is 2, so this energy weapon is terrible. Lucky. You know, I still need to research this headshot mechanic, because I don't get it. I still don't get when it's a good idea to do this. It does 200% damage, and it makes it so you're not quite half as likely to hit. Which means, theoretically, you should do, on average, more damage. Except the fact that it reduces your critical hit chance to 0%. So how does that work out? I have no idea. Is it for when you're over 100% chance to hit? Maybe then it's better? Like if you're behind cover and... I don't know how the math works exactly. I don't know if you can ever be above 100%. I imagine you can, though. I mean, like, right now I'm at 95% chance to hit this guy. And if you're behind cover, that increases your chance by 10%, right? So would that mean I would effectively have 105% chance to hit? So then if I got the headshot 40% chance reduction, it would actually end up being a 35% reduction? Like, I have no idea. Yeah. Yeah, it's time to unleash some whoop-ass. Should I burst you? I'm probably not gonna kill you, though. Yeah, I guess I'll burst you. Well... Nah, there's no need to burst. Can't hit them both. This guy can die no problem. Shit. Alright, I guess I'll just do this. I love how these camera angles... Oh my god. I love how these camera angles make it, like, impossible to see the action. That chance to hit is terrible. Just don't do anything. He's not my combat guy anyway. We got this guy. I'm gonna use shotgun ammo. Let's save some ammo. Hello. Now hold on, is there something over here? Can I go down here? No, I can't go down there. That's where I came in, okay. Wait, can I not go down here? No, I can't, that's from before the level transition. Or past the level transition area. Yeah. Oh, some more goop. I guess if I was missing one, I could have just gotten it here.
Copy, Ranger. Congratulations.
Three skill points, not enough. Pizeppi, seven skill points, ooh, that is enough. Well, your energy weapon skill is already really good. She has high intelligence, right? Yeah, fairly high. It says average, but that's actually above average. You know, she is very limited being only an energy weapon person. And her skill points are, I mean, her perception and energy weapons and smartass are already pretty high. I could start her down another pathway. Like, what am I missing? As far as, like, weapon people. I don't want a melee person, so it's gotta be ranged. I don't have any pistol people. I don't have any SMG people. I guess that's probably the big one. I don't have any SMG people. But I have a shit ton of SMG ammo. I mean, look at this. I could start her down that pathway. She'd be pretty bad at it for now. But I don't know if I want two energy weapon people. I don't know, it's hard to tell. I don't know how useful energy weapons are going to be. Are they going to be just occasional, or eventually am I going to get to use them all the time? I think she can spare it, though. I mean, I'm not going to be upgrading her perception skill, because that's, you know, that's Helen's thing. Yeah, let's do it. Let's diversify our ammo usage and stuff. She's only level 3, it's quite bad. Okay, so what's my best smig? I know I have a ton of them. Got an Uzi. Looks like just an Uzi. I mean, okay, I'm also missing heavy weapons, I suppose. But, I want somebody to have a I want her to have a reliable weapon skill. Energy weapons are obviously not reliable in terms of being able to use them in combat in general. Same with heavy weapons, you just don't have that many heavy weapons, really. And they eat through so much ammo. They're a very occasional thing. So, let's go with the Uzi. What does this thing do? 66% chance to hit. Yeah, that's not very good. Yeah, it's all that burst firing. So you can do a normal burst or a double burst. 6 shots. It's got a very low range. How much health does she have? How does that compare? Huh? It's decent. Alright. That uses what kind of ammo? 9mm? That's this stuff, right? No, it's not. Shit, okay. Well, that stuff? How much of that do I have? Doesn't seem like that much. Oh, got a bit. Yeah, 65, that's not bad. Oh my god. This is so gonna blow up. Yulia, if you want to keep what little clothes you have, then please succeed. Ah. M24. Is that better than the Argent? It definitely does more damage. The nice thing about the Argent is the fact that it uses a different kind of ammo. Range is better. Capacity is worse. Armor penetration is less. More damage. I think it's just better, for the most part. The only bad thing about it is the kind of ammo that it uses. I'll keep using the Origin for now, though. Oh god, now she's overloaded. I really need to dump some of this stuff. Okay, I know the stuff like the skins are worth very little, but they're very heavy. So let's dump that crap. There we go. Ooh. Seems to be a back entrance. Let's try to shoot this thing open. Oh shit, there's raiders in there. You think they'll hear this? I'm just gonna go around. I'm not gonna waste a grenade on that stupid thing. Because I think it's more tactically advantageous for me to just try to snipe them from afar up here. Rather than come around the back and then just be in close quarters with them. Ah, damn it, sight is blocked. I know they're gonna try to shoot me. Look at this guy staring up. It's like, hey, what's going on up there? Let's just have everybody shoot. Oh, there's more of them. Hi. I didn't see you. Let's get up in his face. Should force him to move. That's a terrible chance to hit. Ooh. Your easy pickings. Alright, so they have SMGs. Oh, we can throw a little bit of that back at them. Also, Yulia is not doing too well. This is definitely a burst fire time. Yeah, these guys don't have enough armor to use the energy weapons. Let's go for this guy. How much damage did that do? 72 total? That's not bad. It's a lot of ammo, though. Alright, now they're all in cover. It's time to move. There's really nowhere good for me to go. I suppose this is okay. Aw, he exploded! some height advantage. Yeah, I should have placed my people a lot better. Okay, we're good. Should I double burst fire? I probably should. Well, no, I don't need to. Well, I could shoot twice in this mode anyway, so no, we're good. That's so cool. Rat-a-tat-tat, and you're dead. Do I have an angle on this guy? Yeah, we have a height disadvantage, but at least he's not in cover from this angle. I don't really want to heal Yulia too much, because she's about to level. I'll do her twice. I'm surprised I didn't overload us. Bleeding looks so nasty. Just said loose dirt remains where something once was buried. That's just the message for when you've dug something up, right? Yeah, it's when you right-click on one of those things. Okay. Just checking. Alright, let's see what the Diamondback Militia is doing down here. I wonder if they're gonna try to shoot me. No, they shouldn't. Hi. Nina. Well, if it ain't my favorite big damn heroes. I know Captain Sadler gave you an objective. I don't much care if you accept it or not. I'm supposed to tell you that this pipe connects to the underground launch facility. If you can get the damn thing open, you're in. Underground launch facility. You know, if I could get in there... if I can get in there, I wonder if I could just disable the nuke on my own. Because, I mean, regardless of what happens, regardless of whether I want the Diamondback Militia to take control, or if I want the Servants of the Mushroom Cloud to take control, or maybe I want neither. Regardless, I want that nuke disabled. So if I could do that, that would be great. Torn stockings! Let me see what those look like. Who's got them? Wait, I passed him? There? No. Oh, there they are. okay. I guess that kind of completes her outfit. It's better than nothing. God, I need to find some proper clothes. Alright. Got nothing else to say to you. There's a lock. Let's see if I can do it. Yeah, it's not too bad. Hold on, I think I have a lock-picking buff, don't I? I think it's on Vulture's Cry. Yeah. That should make it a bit easier. Yep. Stay back. I need to do science. Never mind that lockpicking is not science, but I have a lab coat, so everything's science. Well done, Rangers. Guess you ain't as pussified as we heard. Good luck in there. Oh, thank you. You're so nice. Do I actually want to go in there, though? I mean, obviously I'm not supposed to be in there, so if anybody sees me, they're gonna probably try to shoot. Kinda wanna explore the other paths first. Wait, why can't I open that? That's weird. It's locked, and I can't use lockpicking on it. Hmm? Okay, it's a super, super special one, I guess. Anyway, let's see what's up here. You know, if this is the underground entrance, then this is probably the proper entrance to the place up here, right? Maybe not. God, this place is so big. Look at this. I've only explored like a third of the map. The thing is, I'd like to go in there properly before I go in through the side entrance to the launch facility. Because, like, I want to talk to Dr. whatever her name was, see if we can get some cybernetic upgrades or something. I don't want to piss them off before I've had a chance to do that. Oh, that's a monk. That's good. That's a good sign. Ooh! Mr. Taggart. Could finally sell all my shit. Alright, well, these commandos and raiders are undoubtedly gonna try to kill us, so shall we just speed this process along? Yes, come to one place, why don't you? Thank you. It jammed on the second shot, damn it. Go. Yulia leveled up.
Copy, Ranger. Congratulations.
Three skill points, not enough to do anything. Yeah, there's a bunch of goop around here. Might have to throw a grenade for this. Do I have any more dirty bombs? I think I do, because I don't mind throwing those. Yeah. Just gotta wait for the cloud to clear. Floating debris. Debris. Zebra. Glacier. Vitamin. Oh. Right, I threw it a little bit too close to the thing I wanted to get into. It's okay. Looks like there's a little pebble left inside. I can't seem to select it, though. I can't seem to select it. It's showing up as a highlight, but I can't click it. It's like hidden under the dirt or something. Do I have to dig it out? Shit. Oh well. That's probably just like a couple rounds and some dentures. Oh. I didn't open that. Oh well. Hello, black. Black. Dinges? Dingus? Am I crazy, or is that the biggest pipe bomb I've ever seen? What the hell are you doing up there, buddy? You don't plan on crashing this cowboy party, do you? Lace bustier. Can't I find any normal clothes? Alright, see how it looks on Theodore. Found you some new clothes, Theodore! Just one more swig, then I'm off. What did that say? Peering over the ridge, you see a naked, wild-haired old man sitting with what looks like a World War II-era bomb, resting on the ground. He is drinking straight from a bottle and smells like a bucket of piss poured into a vat of snake squeezins. He giggles at you as you approach. A World War II-era bomb. In other words, literally a pipe bomb model just scaled up. Oh my god. Skinny as a skeleton, and obviously sloshed on snake squeezins, and old man sits on the ground with a hefty piece of artillery. Well, and old man, what do you have to say for yourself? Perception bonus. A frail old drunk carrying a bomb that size? No way. That thing has got to be a fake. Yeah, if that's an actual bomb, that would weigh half a ton, at least. Howdy, fellas. How's it going? Say, are you Rangers? Well, goddamn, just the fellas I want to see. I want to report a crime against humanity. These goddamn mad monks are perpetrating a fraud. Yes, indeed they are. So your bomb is a dud too? Caught that, did you? That's right. I'm calling out their fake god with a fake of my own. But they won't know that, will they? Long as you don't tell them. So, shh. Wait, so you're saying Titan is a fake? That's something you want to be pretty sure of before you test it. Because if you're wrong, well, goodbye, desert. The desert has now turned into a wasteland. Which is ironic because it's already a wasteland. But it'll become wastelandier. So, Titan's a fake? Glug, glug, glug. That's right. It's a goddamn crime what the monks are doing. Them varmints scare tribute out of everybody who comes through this canyon by telling them they got some kind of a god under their temple, and they'll kill us all if and we don't obey. Well, I call bullshit. I ain't never seen no god. and I don't believe there is one. They're using a boogeyman to steal our cargo, and I ain't taking it no more. I can't really trust anything this guy says, but it could be valuable information. Okay, so where the hell did you get that bomb? Found this baby in an old army base to the east of here. And I'm gonna use it to call their bluff and prove that big bad Titan ain't there. If they don't bring him out, I'm gonna drop this old, blockbuster on their nose and blow them all to kingdom come. Just like they've been blowing up everybody else all these years. Yep. Right after having another little drink, pardon me. Ooh, smartass. Titan is a bluff? Well, I think we could have already established that, but let's... anything locked behind a skill check is probably better information than something that is not. Of course it's a bluff. Ain't you heard the rumor about how one of the monks got sent east to find another god, because theirs was dead? And how the runaway monk lost his religion? And now they're scared shitless he's gonna come back and spoil their game? Okay, is it a rumor or is it true? It's true, I swear. I heard it from a friend who heard it from a gal whose sister washes clothes for the assistant to the assistant of the head monk, Father Enola. It has to be true. The monk's got nothing down in that temple of theirs except a lot of hot air. It's a fraud. I'm 100% certain. Well, 90% at least. Maybe 80. Shit. Better have another drink to get my courage up. Excuse me. Okay, yeah. I'm gonna make sure before I test that. Where did the runaway monk run away to? Ooh, a little bit woozy. Sorry, fellas. Gotta lie down for a bit. Then I'll go after them monks. You see if I don't. You... wake the fuck up. We ain't done. Wake up! Alright, let's do some surgery on him. You fuck. Why I oughta. Why I oughta. Guess I should have picked my dialogue options more carefully. I wonder if he'll actually be de-boozed when I come back. After a while. Let's ponder this for a moment. I don't even know what that means. I just succeeded in using coffin nail cigarettes on Black Dingus. What does that even mean? How do you succeed in using cigarettes on somebody? I don't understand. Is there some sort of a... Have I ever found coffee? Like, can I wake him up? I don't know. I'll come back later and see if he's woken up. In the meantime, I think I better end this episode before it becomes way too long. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.